Burkina Faso's incoming president, Roch Marc Kabore, highlighted the economy, social governance and jobs for the young and women among the priorities for his government. The former prime minister took office as the country's first new leader in almost 30 years following his election last month. The ceremony at an indoor stadium in the capital marks a pivotal moment in a democratic transition in the West African country. This after veteran leader Blaise Compaoré was overthrown in a popular uprising in October 2014.
In any case, the task of being the president of a country is always, even though exciting, a very difficult one. I must let you know that we inherit a context that is not simple at all in terms of the economy and finance. So we have challenges ahead of us, and with the government we are going to work towards taking on these challenges.
Landlocked Burkina Faso produces cotton and gold, but remains, for the most part, impoverished. Its economy has slowed due to lower global commodity prices and reduced investment during the democratic transition that began after Compaoré fell.
I would say what we have to work on initially is the establishment of good economic and social governance. I would say this first issue is important. Then we have to work on education, health, clean water, agriculture. Therefore, we have to boost the economy in order to create jobs for the youth, women, etc. It is very important we work on that.
The government said the economy would expand by 4 to 4.5% this year from a World Bank figure of 6% growth in 2014. The swearing-in marks the end of an interim government that held power in the wake of Compaoré's overthrow. Most of the country's leaders since independence from France in 1960 have come to power through coups, including Compaoré in 1987 and his predecessor Thomas Sankara 4 years earlier. Kabore served under Compaoré but went into opposition in 2014. The election could serve as an example to other African countries where rulers in Burundi, Rwanda and Congo Republic have sought extensions of their mandates through constitutional changes. Celestine Carone, CCTV.